we were on our way to sing in a little town. Trying to get there before the sun went down. We had the old CB on channel 19. And there came a little boy's voice on the radio line. He said, "Breaker, breaker, 19, is anyone there? Come on back, someone, and talk to Teddy Bear." I picked up the microphone and said, "Talk to me, Teddy Bear." And the little boy's voice came back on the air. He asked, "Who do we have on that end?" I told him my name, and he began. He said, "I'm not supposed to bother you people out there, 'cause my mom says you're busy and to stay off the air. But you see, I get lonely and it helps to talk, 'cause that's about all I can do. I'm crippled and I can't walk." And I came back and told him to pick up his mic. And I talked to him as long as he liked. "This was my daddy's radio," the little boy said, "but I guess it's mine and mom's now, 'cause dad is dead. My dad had a wreck about a month ago. He was trying to get home in a blinding snow. My mom has to work now to make ends meet. And I'm not much help with my two crippled feet. She says not to worry, we'll be all right. But I hear her crying sometimes late at night. There's one thing I want more than anything else, you see. Oh, I know you people are too busy to be bothered with me. You see, my dad used to take me for a ride when he was home. But I guess that's all over now, since dad is gone. And you know, not one person came on the CB while that little crippled boy talked to me. On my face, tears began to run down as I thought about my loved ones near that old Jackson town. He said dad was gonna take mom and me with him later this year. I remember him saying, "Someday this place will even be yours, Teddy Bear. But I know I'll never see him again. So I'll just sit here and keep in touch with all my CB friends." He said, "Well, Teddy Bear is gonna get off the air and leave you alone, 'cause it's about time for Mama to come home. But you give me a call when you're passing through, and I'll sure be happy to talk to you." I said, "Oh, where do you live, my little friend?" And then our conversation started all over again. He said, "My house is not hard to find. I live on Jackson Street, 229. And as I turned the corner, oh, I was really, really shocked, 'cause cars and trucks were lined up for nearly two blocks. People for miles around caught Teddy Bear's call, and that little crippled boy was having himself a ball. For as fast as one driver would bring him in, someone else would pick him up and take him out again. You better believe I took my turn to ride Teddy Bear. Then I carried him back and put him down in his chair. Lord, if I never live to see happiness again, believe me, I saw it that day in the face of that young man. We took up an offering for him before his mother came home. Then we said goodbye, and then we were gone. And he shook my hand with a mile-long grin and said, "So long, I hope to see you again." Lord, I drove back to that interstate with tears in my eyes. And I turned on the CB and there was another surprise. "Breaker, breaker, 19," a voice came on the air. Said, "Just a word of thanks from Mama Teddy Bear." She said, "Well, I will always say a special prayer for you, 'cause you just made my little boy's dream come true." Slowly she said, "I sign off now before I start to cry." Then she said, "May God bless each and every one of you tenfold, and goodbye."